Out of my light of knowing are my two lights of thinking, born as sexed pairs of opposites for repetition as sexed pairs of opposites. Behold in me the one light from which a seeming two lights appear as pairs of rhythmically interchanging opposites. These are my light messengers. They are my workers, which build my image forms and give them back to me, devoid of form. They are the pulsing heartbeat of my body, the makers of forever borning cycles of my imagining in forms of things. The two are equal halves of one. They never can become one. They forever interchange to simulate a balanced unity which they never find, for they never can be aught but two.
All pattern thought creations of God or man are the interweavings of the spectrum colors of the two electric opposites of light waves into the patterned designs of those thoughts. Creation might be likened to the tapestry weaver who knows that one idea as a whole, then thinks it into parts, then records those parts by interweaving their spectrum colors into the many forms which, together, manifest the whole idea.
Balanced interchange simulates oneness by interchange between pairs of opposites. It is the principle of equal giving between all moving pairs of unbalanced opposites, which constitute this dual electric universe. In it is the instability of effect. Instability is forever seeking to find stability. It can never find it, but it can simulate it by balancing its instability through equality of interchange.
The pulse beat, the swinging pendulum, the in-breathing and out-breathing of living things all exemplify God's one law of rhythmic, balanced interchange. Any deviation from that law in the heartbeat of a man would endanger his continuance. But when there is a rhythmic, balanced interchange between the two compression and expansion opposites, man's life continues to function at maximum.
I, the one, am not divided into two, as pairs of opposites of me. I divide the two extensions of my thinking, but I am not my thinking, nor am I two. When man thinketh man alone, denying me, then is man's image man's, not mine and man's? For the pattern of my balanced rhythmic images within man may not be seen in him, nor may the glory of my light be seen in him or known by him. When man thinketh me, through knowing me, then is he patterned by my image as I am he. When man thinketh me in him, then is man's balance absolute. When man so thinketh, then hath he all power that I, thy father, mother, thinker of creation, hath.
The electric universe is the negative projected principle. It is effect. The two moving lights of the electric universe are two equal halves which express themselves in opposite directions. Their sole purpose is to oppose. Opposites which violently oppose and void each other can never become one, nor can they attract each other.
Interchange between these two unbalanced opposites is the basis of all motion in this rhythmic universe. Sex mates are two equal halves of one. They never can be one. They can never unite, for they are the opposites of motion. Opposites of motion can cease to be, and by thus ceasing to be, they can give birth to the other opposite. But they never can be other than opposite.
They can interchange with their opposites with every pulse beat, and they do. Each opposite is born from the other. Each pulse beat brings each opposite nearer to voidance of each, and complete interchange into the other. It becomes the other sequentially, at the halfway point in its cycle, but it is still an opposite. Opposites oppose. They never perform any other office than to oppose.
Opposition alone produces the idea of separateness in a universe of one inseparable thing. The opposite of water is water vapor. Water is a compressed condition. It is the father light. Water vapor is the expanded condition of water. It is of the mother light. They are two halves of one which never can be one.
The supreme effort of this book is to have you comprehend that creation is a division of the eternal one, into countless twos of sex-conditioned opposites, which eternally seek to void their division by uniting as one.
Creation is a mind-imagined journey of electrically divided male and female opposites in increasingly greater speed and power in the direction of each other, where they unite and rest to redivide and return with ever-increasing speed and decreasing power to the zero of rest in the magnetic light of mind from which they sprang into action. Creation is an illusion which simulates substance by multiplying the speed of centripetal motion and loses its appearance of substance by multiplying its centrifugal speed.
Polarity and sex are one. The two poles which unite are male and female opposites in all matter. The idea that sex is solely a characteristic of organic bodies is not a true concept. Sodium and chlorine are as male and female as man and woman are male and female. Every particle of matter in the universe is bisexual, either male or female preponderant, and these pairs are electrically divided and projected together in the ratios of force which Newton gave to the acceleration of gravity.
The textbooks tell you that there are two kinds of electricity, a positive kind and a negative opposite. Let us show you how impossible and illogical this is, and how contrary it is to nature's processes in the construction of matter. We again repeat the fact that electricity does only one thing. It divides an equilibrium into equal pairs and compresses them until they unite to create an explosive condition around a still point of gravity. When that purpose has been completed, electricity slowly dies in all masses until all motion has ceased in them.
How was it that early investigators decided that there were two opposite kinds of electricity instead of the one kind which produces motion? It was because the two opposite conditions of living and dying, growing and decaying, heating and cooling, polarizing and depolarizing, and all other effects of motion are expressed in seemingly opposite directions by seemingly opposite forces.
There are no opposite directions or opposite forces, however. There are but divided sexes which exert the same force and in the same direction. The one force is compression, and the one direction is spiral. That which seems to be two are one when they are united. They could not unite if they were pursuing opposite directions, nor could they be one if they were opposites. One's senses are very deceptive. They convincingly make one believe the very opposite of what they manifest. This has led to some confusion on the part of many students. What is often interpreted as opposition in the term twin opposing vortices is that one pole is negative and the other positive. It is believed that vortices inwind from the north and unwind from the south, as pictured here.
There is only one force, electricity, which exerts itself in one direction, which is spiral. Both north and south poles charge inward towards each other. The south pole does not discharge. The discharge happens at the equator in the east-west pole in the direction of electric south, which is the six faces of the magnetic cube.
The universe is made up entirely of electric thought waves. Thought waves are nature's two-way guns, which are loaded with the energy of mind desire to give out from its centering self to all the universe. That is the explosive which motivates this universe. That is what makes creation appear and disappear. If you can imagine these two-way spiral guns, which are shaped like the spirals shown throughout our work, and if you can imagine them placed muzzle to muzzle all through the universe, you have one part of the picture clearly in mind. If you also imagine these two-way spiral guns to be of both atomic and stellar dimensions, you will clarify the picture somewhat.
The only thing now to complete the picture is in discharging all of these cosmic guns right into each other's muzzles so that the explosive, which is projected, collides as hot bodies, which are frozen into solids as they are ejected from the muzzles of those polarizing guns. That is the way that paired units become mated systems, which complete the purposefulness of the universe by regiving to the Creator all that the Creator had given to them.
The problem has also been compounded by the Russells' use of north and south electric, which gets confused with north and south so-called magnetic poles, which are in reality male and female gravity poles. They control the sex-divided spiraling rings with their gravity centers.
This contradiction appears in The Secret of Light. At the two points upon the still shaft of the turning sphere where the shaft penetrates its surface are the magnetic poles of still light which control the balance of each sphere's turning. One of these is the north magnetic pole which controls the winding of the sphere into density by centripetal electric force, and the other is the south magnetic pole which controls its unwinding centrifugally into space.
This is a conceptual error which is opposed to the Russell's work. The way it should read is, the north electric pole or gravity center controls the winding of the sphere into density, and the south electric pole, the six external faces of the cubic wave field, control its unwinding centrifugally into space.
This has confused many students of the Russell's cosmology, especially when combined with this image from Dr. Tim Binder's book, In the Wave Lies the Secret of Creation.
This image was qualified by Dr. Binder with the following statement. In this illustration of abstract male and abstract female as pure types, Dr. Russell revealed the secret for a new transportation device, or an engine. The net effect of polarizing the field of Earth, or any body as shown, is to move it through its surrounding medium, in the direction of the arrows pointing to the top of the painting. This direction would be as close to linear as possible in a universe where there is no linear motion. The surrounding medium moves in the direction of the downward pointing arrows. Acceleration in this abstract approaches infinity.
In The Secret of Light, Dr. Russell said, the uncreated universe is light undivided, which could be symbolized by either a uniformly black or white canvas. Furthermore, he said, the created universe is light divided into mated pairs. Something like this diagram of an over-unity implosion turbine designed by Victor Schauberger, for example.